me to talk a little about how do you record and the kind of, you know, preparation that you do to record your video. So I would say that the first thing that you need to be mindful of is the space that you're recording in. So remember that you should stand against the wall and record. And even if you have something behind you, it should not be cluttered. Imagine that, you know, if this bookshelf did not look neat like the way it is now, it might just distract you, right? You're looking at me, and suppose it was, you know, it wasn't arranged this well, then it would have surely, you know, distracted you. And we do not want that. Right? We want all the eyes on us. So make sure that your background is clutter-free. It's best to stand against a wall, record a story. And also, there should not be any movement behind you when you're recording a story. Like, I did not have any of my family members moving behind when I was telling a story. So ensure that when you're recording, you have a quiet space, noise-free, away from distractions. You should be very, you know, calm. And then you record the story. And it is good to record a story in a small room than a large room. A small room with some furniture, maybe a carpet on the floor, curtains around you, so that your voice doesn't sound echoey. Okay? Now, when it comes to lighting, ensure that you are visible on the camera. It's not dark. There are no shadows. You can do that by ensuring that you record it in natural light. And when I say natural light, let the light come in through the window. And again, the window shouldn't be behind you. Then it will appear very dark. So the window, the source of light should be in front of you. Okay. Now, in case, you know, when you are recording and you live on a busy street, or, you know, there is a constant traffic flow, or there's some construction happening near your house, then just be mindful. Plan ahead. When would you record? These are very small things, but, you know, it will make your recording very powerful. Okay, it doesn't matter which device you record on. It could be a laptop, it could be a desktop, it could be your phone. Everything is fine as long as you keep it at an eye level. Like, if you keep it up above your eye level, then you would be recording like this. Or if you keep it way down, you will be looking at it like this. But we want you to keep it at the eye level. And the distance, you know, between you and the device should be just an arm. You know, it should be one arm, like about 2 to 3 feet. If you're able to take care of this, be rest assured your recording will come out really well. Now, when you have to choose a story, there are hundreds of stories on Storytime at Nine. And the criteria is that you have to pick up a story that you heard on Storytime at Nine. So pick any story, a story that you liked. Not because, you know, you want to tell a story from America, so you listen to an American storyteller, and whether you like it or not, you just pick the story. Don't do that. That could be a big mistake, because if you don't like the story, you can't tell it well. So listen to a few stories, because the deadline is sometime in the first week of June. So you still have time. Spend some time watching some videos, see which story you like, and pick that up. And once you pick it up, don't feel pressurized that you have to memorize the story verbatim, like word by word, you have to remember the story. It's not what we are looking at. We want to just express your love for that story. So tell it in your own words. So listen to the storyteller a couple of times. Listen to that story a few times. And then write it in your words. And then you practice it. And when you practice, try to play with your voice. Okay, suppose it's a big lion or a ghost in the story. Then you can make your voice very heavy. Okay, or suppose somebody funny like Patty, a cute little character. Then you can give her a very soft, gentle voice. And if it is a naughty child, you can talk from your nose, and it can be a cute little voice coming from your nose, a squeeze pinched voice. So see if you can play with the voice. And remember, when you tell, you know, when you're rehearsing for the story or when you record the story, do not just pause whenever you want. That's a big mistake that people make. Like, for example, if I'm telling a story and I say, oh, she was so happy, she was so excited. And then her mother came. And then this happened. So every few minutes, if I pause, it can break the flow of the story. So, you know, I'm not, I'm, I cannot share all the tips. That would be difficult, but these are small things that I'm sharing, which I have seen, you know, people generally are not very careful about. But I'm sure now that you know, you will be careful about it. Now, when you might, some of you might be happy using props, may bring a puppet or a drawing for your story. Feel free to do what you want. It's your story. Okay? If you do not want to use a prop, it's absolutely fine. But when you tell the story, show it as well. Okay, when I was doing takku 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 takku, and when I was making party eat the pan, I was trying to chew the pan. I did not say that party used to chew the pan and then she would drink the juice, gulp down the juice, and spit it out. I did not say it only. I said it and I did it. So when you are doing the story, act out certain parts of the story. Show what the character is doing and tell as well. Okay, so remember the lighting, the space, the camera distance, your voice, be expressive. If you want to use props, you use it. If you don't want to use, don't use it. Okay.